was squirming like a worm in there. Don't you love it when they pull the war hero excuse? Actually, maybe you don't. Now would be a bad time to forget how to drive.
I'd have expected a cad like Arnett to be a better liar.
Taking us, Henry.
You got a pretty funny idea of what keeping a low profile means, Phelps.
Never stepped foot in Okinawa.
Money and fast. Get in there and find out what he pawned. I'll stay with him, see how he intends to spend the money. Too much slack.
Huff it, Phelps. I'll bring the car around when I'm done here.
Risk losing the trail. Slack. I get closer. That's right, Mexico City. One-way ticket, please. Next available seat.
That would be one day from now. Is that okay?
It's going to have to be. LAPD, the man who just came in here, he bought a ticket?
Yes, sir, to Mexico City, tomorrow night.
If you hear from him again, don't mention this conversation.
What have you got?
He bought a ticket from Mexico City, tomorrow night.
That's good, but this is better.
Oh my God, it's Fabergé.
Should have seen the look on the pawnbroker's face when I told him to hand it over. The guy who owned the joint thought it was worth at least 10 large for a cigarette case. Arnett only got 600 clams.
Message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Messages, please.
Yes, Detective. Detectives Bukowski and Galloway request you return to the Hollywood Station. They have information in the Julia Randall case.
Any luck with the arrest record check on Jimmy LeBlanc?
Yes, Detective. Jimmy LeBlanc's last arresting officer was Patrolman Fred Wallace. He's posted the Hollywood 9th Beat Sunset Boulevard between Gordon and Wilcox.
Thanks for your help.
Ah, one of these days.
Ticket to Mexico. Old Henry's looking as guilty as a dog next to a pile of dog shit.
What's his motive?
I can think of a few, but I'd put my money south of the belt. One guy plus two dames always equals problems.
Give him a hand.
Right behind you, Wallace. Detective Phelps.
Wallace, go left. I'm going right after this little prick in the alley.
Go out the gun. Find some cover! I'm wide open here!
Thanks. Outstanding warrant, armed robbery. Knocked over a drugstore back there, and it looks like he brought his whole posse with him. Bad luck for them.
They're all yours now. We need some information.
Ever heard of a burglar goes by the name of Jimmy LeBlanc?
Sure. I nabbed Jimmy on a burglary beef a couple of years back. They cut through a music shop and into a jewelry store. He got 4 years. I miss his partner, though.
His partner?
Big guy. I had him cornered, and he picked up this huge display case and threw it out a plate glass window. Then he vaulted out of there like something out of Barnum and Bailey.
Got away.
I would have had him, except for LeBlanc yelling, "Run for it, Willie."
And you think he was an acrobat of some sort?
More like a strongman, a wrestler, or a boxer, that kind of thing.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
You haven't done too badly yourself.
You're suggesting LeBlanc is still working with Willie?
A strong man held down Randall while someone administered morphine. Someone with muscle opened up LeBlanc's skull.
Could be.
Phelps! Son of a bitch!
We caught up with Mal. He's given us the dope on LeBlanc. He worked burglaries with a big guy. Goes by the name of Willie. He might be our killer. Can you work boxing gyms, the Y, promoters, that kind of stuff?
Since when have you started giving orders, Phelps? And where's the burglary angle? There was no sign of him.
That's where our net comes in. Next stop, we speak to Lacey about a list of recent burglaries.
The guy's a bum. His office is a front, and he's behind on the rent and his phone bill.
And he's skipping town. Tomorrow.
Let's get him in and beat it out of him.
Do you want to bring in the killer, Rusty?
It could be too smart for your own good, Phelps. We've been talking about that, haven't we, Roy? Stefan?
Finbar?
Sir, I need the contraband list. Items stolen over the last year.
Hang on, I'll dig out a copy for you. Here you go.
Thanks.
Is the cigarette case on there?
It's here. Arnett must be out of his mind trying to move this while under a murder cloud.
Julia Randall's ring.
It's here. Even the engagement ring was purloined. Arnett is a cad.
Every peacetime soldier's wildest dream. With our new house and land packages, your shining knight can rule his very own kingdom on a half-acre block.
So you and Rusty have been having discussions. And you would like to tell me, partner?
Valves, don't be so touchy. Rusty had his best ever clearance rate working with you. Even if the cases he worked on can't be discussed. We were just comparing notes. You're a Boonaroo case man, Phelps. One of the best I've ever seen.
Thanks.
You gotta learn to take a compliment, Phelps.
A hopped-up model, a cad, and a circus freak. Only in L.A.
Fairy tales of the rich and famous.
More like pathetic tales of the desperate to be rich and famous. Junkie Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
Arnett, LeBlanc, and Willie.
Don't you go putting the pieces together again before they fit, Phelps. Listen to your old pal Rusty. Or should I say Finbar?
I wouldn't call him that if I were you.
What do you care? It doesn't sound like you're the top of his Christmas card list.
He gives everyone a hard time. That's just how he is.
Whatever gets you through the day, Cole.
In all my life through, I've been black and blue. Hey, now I am white, way down deep inside, but baby, that don't help my case. Honey, just because I can't hide what is on my face, I'm so forlorn. My heart is torn, I feel the thorn, oh, why was I born?
There goes a week's wages. What are you doing?
House.
LAPD, ma'am. Is Mrs. Evestrom in?
She is. Would you follow me, sir?
I am Mrs. Evestrom. How may I help you?
We appear to have recovered some stolen goods that belong to you, ma'am.
Yes, of course. That terrible burglary. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you, ma'am. We have some questions, if you don't mind.
Why would I mind, young man, if you are returning 43 pieces of my property?
Okay, before we get down to that, I'll have a scotch. Thanks, straight up.
Maria, can you get the detective a drink, please?
Can you describe to us what was stolen?
It would be easier to describe what wasn't stolen, Detective. A priceless tiara that has been in the family for 50 years. A Fabergé cigarette case that was worth $25,000.
Why are you lying about the value of your jewelry, Mrs. Eavesdrom?
Who do you think you are, making heinous accusations in my own home?
We recovered the cigarette case from a pawnbroker. No one knows the real value of an item better than those guys.
I inflated its value for the insurance claim. There, are you satisfied? My daughter's boyfriend was quite taken with the case. I think he was even more disappointed than I was when it was stolen.
What can you tell us about the burglary?
A terrible night, at least a year ago. But let's not go into that. Let's talk about what you've recovered.
Were you in the house when the burglary took place?
Good heavens, no. I was at a social function held by a Dr. Harold Stoneman and his lovely wife. I returned home and all of my things were missing.
That's about it for now, Mrs. Eavesdrom. The department will get in touch and let you know how you can recover your valuables.
You have only mentioned a few of the items that have been stolen, Detective. What else has been recovered?
You see, Phelps, that's why you get the drinks in early.
Hello, Mother. Hello, Detectives. What is going on?
We'd like to ask exactly the same question.
You have met my daughter?
This morning at work. Oh, Mother and Father divorced. I took my father's name.
The detectives recovered some of the things that were stolen, darling.
Well, what did you find?
A sapphire ring on the corpse of Julia Randall.
What are you talking about?
Your engagement ring, Miss Swanson. Would you be surprised to know that it was part of the proceeds of a burglary?
That's an outrageous allegation.
Yes, it is. I suggest we go straight to Henry Arnett's place and sort this mess out.
Friends, quality is an American trait, and Americans recognize quality, whether they're in New York.
Missing something here. Arnett is obviously arranging the burglaries.
That's my fiancé you're making scurrilous accusations about.
And Randall was obviously his partner.
But neither of them are the type to creep apartments.
You're being ridiculous, both of you. There's a very good explanation for all of this.
What a sog in it, sister. You're being played for a patsy and you're not even smart enough to see it.
Take the next right turn. Look where you're going! Straight on. Keep straight. Make a right turn.
Welcome, sir.
Come on, sister.
I'm sorry. Are you a resident?
It really is.
LAPD detectives. We're here to speak to Henry Arnett.
Oh, Mr. Arnett? Apartment 30. You can take the lift.
Thank you.
Well, isn't this just nice and awkward?
Case.
Go on, get out.
Put your hands in the air. Give it up, LAPD. Don't make me chase you.
Looks like he got you good, Phelps.
Yeah, he really packs a wallop. How did I get back here?
Under your own steam, miraculously. You came in through the window, said hello, and then keeled over.
How was Arnett?
He's coming around, too. He's all hopped up. Good time to get some answers.
You missing something, Henry?
Incidental. So. Doesn't tell me anything. Optimistic call. Thank you.
You told Heather you're honeymooning without her? Vacheron Constantine. It's an extremely expensive watch, Henry.
A graduation present from my parents.
We know all about the jewelry ring. You and Randall and LeBlanc and Willie doing the legwork.
I'm in the fashion business.
You're lying, Henry.
How can you prove that I'm involved, detective?
Because you pawned a Fabergé cigarette case today for $600, a case that is on a list of stolen items.
It was Julia's idea. Get a list of society parties and find out where and when, and then have the guests burgled. Julia was desperate for money. No matter how much we made, she always wanted more.
Why did Reed and LeBlanc kill Julia Randall?
I wanted to stop, to get out of that life. I was going to marry Heather if she'd have me. Julia told the others that they were out, that she was going to create a new gang.
You're lying, Arnett. I think you ordered them to kill her. It was made to look like suicide, and when the coroner saw through that, you knew it was time to run.
I told you I was involved in the burglaries. I had nothing to do with Julia's death. Why would I need to run?
Have you told Miss Swanson that you're leaving for Mexico City tomorrow night? That it's a one-way ticket?
Henry? Tell me it isn't true.
I had no choice. I wanted to marry Heather. I told Julia I wanted out, and she laughed in my face. I had to pay Willie and Jimmy a fortune to do her, and now I'm completely broke.
What you are, Buster, is under arrest.
Who is Henderson, and what is his involvement?
Tell them what you know, Henry. I'll stand by you if you'll only tell the truth.
There is no Henderson.
Tell me about your first burglary, and don't lie.
I can't remember. I don't keep a list of these things.
Your first burglary was a Dr. Harold Stoneman. Do you want to explain how he is involved, or shall I?
Henderson is Stoneman. He was crazy about Julia. She could get him to do whatever she wished. He threw the parties, and we arranged the burglaries. Julia never let him touch her. She just kept him hanging on the promise. Drove the good doctor almost insane.
Henry Arnett, you are under arrest for burglary and for the murder of Julia Randall.
Henderson is Stoneman, all right? I'm not the guy you want. Go talk to the good doctor.
Oh, we will, knucklehead. Meanwhile, we're fitting you for convict stripes.
The wedding's off.
He only robbed her mother and killed her best friend. Cut the guy some slack.
So how does the doctor fit in?
That's what we're about to find out. Maybe we should ask him to give you a quick once-over. That meathead gave you one hell of a pasting.
I've had worse.
You should have seen yourself staggering back in there like a drunken sailor.
Next time you can take the runner, boy.
I didn't box in the Marines, though, did I?
I should have never told you.
You don't have to miss that picture you wanted to see, nor your favorite star. Now you can see them underway, on board the Theater on Rails.
KZI is a member of the American Century Broadcasting Network.
A fine gentleman playing in ballrooms across America, Louis Armstrong.
Doctor, give us something to make this all better.
Hang on a moment, sister. Tell him it's Henry Arnett, and tell him it's urgent.
I can't do that.
Tell him, or I'll charge you with obstruction of justice.
Doctor, I'm afraid Mr. Arnett is here to see you, and he says it's urgent.
Send him in.
I told you never to come.
Tell us the truth, Doctor.
I'm so glad you came. Prison will be better than insanity, and I'm already half insane with grief.
Do you know that I loved her?
I ruined my life for her, and yet I still love her.
Will you testify in court that Arnett and Randall did these robberies?
They organized the robberies. Julie would get the names of the guests attending my wife's parties. Didn't matter how much money I showered upon her, it was never enough. She never really cared for me.
Doctor, I'm afraid you're under arrest.
Other practice. You'll call Dr. Gerard. No. Please don't cry. I want to see no one. Not my wife, or my children, nor my friends. And I don't want a lawyer. Just lock me up and throw away the key. Done.
Didn't see that coming.
Operator, give me dispatch. I need an ambulance and the coroner immediately to the offices of Dr. Harold Stoneman, 1646 Ivor Street, Hollywood.
En route, Detective. You have a message. Detective Bukowski says the suspect is named Wilson Willie the Wolf Reed, former wrestler. Last known address is an apartment building at the corner of Hollywood and Vine. Detective Bukowski says to meet them there.
On our way. We have an address for the runner.
Let's try and wrap this up then.
That old boy really fell for that broad. She was incredibly beautiful. Would you throw it all away for a woman?
Way of making you pay for your pride.
You're quite the romantic, Phelps. Stick with the percentages. Broken hearts are for chumps.
You're talking from experience.
I certainly am. Oh, I like women as much as the next guy. As long as they're in their place and doing what they're told.
Let me through. I just want
a
big look.
Triple homicide, is that true?
KGI reminds you a great job awaits you in 2 minutes.
He's around here somewhere. A big guy. Neighbors say he always wears basketball shoes and a cream jacket. And get this. The kids around here say he plays the harmonica.
Find the game well and have the commander set up a dragnet. We want the area closed off. We'll take this out of the street.
A harmonica playing wrestler. That's a weird one. Think he knits as well?
Just keep your eyes open and your mouth shut. We don't want him to bolt us.
Wilson Reed, LAPD, give yourself up. Be around here somewhere. No place to go unless he grew wings.
There he is. Wait, the son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch really picked a spot for it up here, didn't he? Julia Randall's folks are flying in from New York tomorrow to claim the body. I saw her on the slab. So perfect. Looked like she was made of porcelain. She really made an impression on me.
Julia had that impact on a lot of men.
Christ, it's cold. You guys did good work here today. Roy! I think you should buy your brother officers a drink.
Do you now? That's very generous of you, Lieutenant.